Everyone, today we are going to start talking about ESET Crash Course. So ESET Crash Course is an entrance exam for the engineering. People who completed diploma like to take ESET and they can go to the engineering course. Crash course is about I would say mostly about 6 months, or you can take up 3 months. So I prefer mostly about taking 6 months as the best one choice. So I'll be telling what is the planning and how you need to go for the crash course thing. So probably the crash course, if you need to start, it's like you need to start from December. So from December to May, it around 6 months. In May, you'll be having your ESET exam. So, and the first thing is, I would like to say 2 points in starting. That is, planning and timetable. Planning and timetable is the most important thing before you're going to read your subjects or anything else. So planning is like what you want to read in the starting sessions. So that's your basic thing. If you want to read your easiest subject, or if you want to read your hardest subject, and read the thing which you are mostly adaptable or you feel comfortable to it. So act according to your wish, I mostly prefer of reading hardest subject among the maths, physics, chemistry and engineering. So that is the best one, starting and reading of these things. And timetable is like, you need to give some time daily for a period of time for every math session or physics session or chemistry or engineering session. So that is very important. So you need to give some time. So give some time. So I mostly prefer in maths is like, you need to, for the crash course, I say that most of the questions in ESET, in maths section, we get 70% of the questions from the previous papers only. So if you can solve only 10 years previous papers, then it's easy to solve 70% of the questions in your exam. So I would like to say you solve previous 10 years of papers, maths papers. And the most important thing is you need to solve bits very more, so that you could have the concept very clearly. And physics and chemistry is like, it's very tough among these maths and engineering. So I would like to say is like, if you are interested in physics and chemistry, then you have to be thorough in the concepts. And in physics, mostly 25 questions. So in that 25 questions, so most of them will be problems. So I mostly prefer that if you can solve MCET questions, for the basic ones, those are enough. And I would say that physics questions will not be in-depth in ESET, but the low-level questions which come from the MCET will be appearing in it. So practice, like be clear with the basic questions and formulas. So next is that chemistry. Chemistry is simple. Chemistry, we don't get many the problems. So I would like to say that be clear with the theory part, so that you can solve most of the questions. That's it. And engineering is the most important thing. Engineering consists of 100 marks. So I would say that if you want to crack very high score, you can mostly probably get in engineering. You try your 100 percent, you'll get 70 to 80 marks in maths, physics, chemistry, if you give your 100%. But if you give your best, your best or your good, you'll get more marks in engineering. Engineering is a bit easy comparative to other things. So first of all, I would say that engineering, focus more on engineering and read mostly third sem subjects, so that you could get most of the syllabus from third sem only. So basically, I'm from electronics background, so you'll be getting third sem analog communication, digital communication, EDC, and EMI, and those all subjects you'll get in third sem only. So I would say that you read starting most of third sem subjects that are very useful for you, and that's very basic thing. And do solve bits daily. This is a very important thing. Do solve bits daily, and you need to solve every day a particular bits. So if you're going to a coaching and if you're listening to some subject or any topic, do solve the bits which are related to them, and you need to recorrect yourself what are the mistakes going on in you, and try focus, because it's a crash course. You need to do two points here. One thing is, if you are good at one thing, make sure that you will be perfect in that. If you're bad at one thing, make sure that you don't make mistake in that. These are the two simple things which I want to give. And do solve the bits daily. And I would prefer two institutes materials. First one is SciMeda, and SciMeda material, ESET Academy. You'll get and this is ESET Academy. And next one is Veda. Veda, and this is also a good one. So if you want to solve maths, physics, chemistry, except you can solve from anywhere, but SciMeda and Veda are good comparative to all of them. These are the things. And one basic and important thing is, you need to solve bits daily. No matter if you are going through some topic or not, you need to solve this daily, because you will be understanding your knowledge. That's it.